risk. Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi, folks. Basil Chapman, 14th day of May. We're looking at the Dow down 81 at 23,166. It was, in fact, much lower. It went down to 22,789, rebounded to a plus. And now it's come back a bit. But what's really important about it, being the third day of this sharp decline, 2,000 points actually from the high of 24,660 on the 29th, it made that cup formation. Remember, one of the patterns that we're looking at the rising wedge, narrowing wedge, stopping at a certain point, and then making a cup for a certain point, meaning after peak D, it went to an F, and then it makes a cup formation. If the cup formation goes decisively above the left side high of 24,066 in this case, 24,660, that would be very positive. If it fails at just a tad above or below and then breaks one-third of the cup formation to a half from the left side high to the base, there's a good chance it's going to test the low. That low was on the 4th of May at 23,361. And if it takes that out, you can get a one-to-one to the downside, which we've just done. All right, so that's accomplished. The Dow has gone from a sell signal to a sell mode. That was at yesterday's close because it went negative underneath the 14-period moving average. MACD was down. Stochastic was down quite sharply. And the on-balance volume was down. But it did hold. The 9 was above the 14-period moving average. But right now, it's just a tad below. The day is young. Let's see how this closes. The weekly chart is still very good, but a lot of resistance at that 14-period moving average in the weekly chart, which has a high of 24,284 right now, that is this week. And we're down at 23,160 with very little chance of even testing the 200-period exponential moving average of 23,948 by tomorrow at 4 o'clock. So that says this weekly chart is at 2 weeks below the previous high. That makes it peak B in the weekly chart. Monthly chart, of course, the middle of the month, there's nothing to talk about there, but the 120-minute chart just went not only to the 200-period moving average support, but for my subscribers to my opening call, we are still long from 210 in the DIA. We're still long the calls from the low of March the 23rd, the exact day of the low, having taken very nice 300% and 400% profit. But now I want to just keep it. I want to see if I can roll it maybe into June, maybe even July, because I think that we need to see how this consolidation, which it is, it's been really a sideways consolidation almost since about the 13th, 14th of April. Even though it went higher, it also went low. So we're in the kind of we're below the midpoint, we're in the lower range. So 22,723 was the ChapmanWave automated support level, and we stopped a little above that, about 50 points above that this morning. That's the level to watch. If we start to close under 22 on any 120-minute basis, in other words, 2 hours, if any two-hour chart closes below 22,723, be careful. All right, in the meantime, back at the ranch, what we are looking at here, let me just do this real quickly. Nope, not there, here. So what we've looked at here is a very interesting, look at the two-minute chart. Gave a beautiful turn signal right at the low of, 2760.25. It didn't do it there. It gave it just after that at about 2765. And it ran up beautifully. Peak A, takes a bit of a breather. I don't like the 136 when you take about six or more measures, or bars, that is, to consolidating, they're making new high, you're invariably going to have a bit of a pullback in the next one. And it did that, and it's done that on every one of these, because it's taken about 4 to 6 bars of consolidation, but it's a stair-step move to the upside. Went to a peak F. I drew this in the den. They watched me draw it. I drew a left-side, right-side price, tie-match to the low right here. That doji close, that was the bar at 10:48 this morning, Eastern Time, at 27.87. And I said, I just drew a triangle up. I did the plumb line to the bottom, drew it to the right, and we went right to 27.86, 25 at 11:44, two bars early, and then it ran up. And then I had drawn in, well, you can't really see it, can you? Over there, I had drawn in a circle to say, that would be my target if we were to turn around, but I'd already drawn in the cup formation. And why did I do that? Because the stochastic was holding well, and the MACD was attempting to turn around. And it shows you how hard it's been. But now it's turning around, and now we've got a nice bounce to the upside. Needs to take out 2803.50 to start leg C. That's number one. There's a two-minute chart, so this is all very, very short-term. I had said in the den that the E-mini needs to take out 2806 to really kind of build some strength. But if it's able to trade above 2000, and I put it about 2014, the high was 2012.50. If it can go to a new recovery high. So what happened here at the beginning of the day, it tried to rally. And it kept on plunging and plunging all the morning. It was just plunging, trying to rally. It went to a peak E, and then it pulled back sharply around from the 2791 area. It plummeted down to the 2760. And then no one could believe it, because every time it failed. So that's why you've got the rally, pull back, rally, pull back, higher, high, higher, low, rally, pull back, higher, high, higher, low. Finally, you get higher, 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 low, peak D, and then a zip. A real quick to a peak F, and then a pullback and a test. So I would say that the people that this move here saw latecomers when they finally got in, I bet the volume, yep, there it is. The volume spiked right there. So I've got the volume, 13, it's called a 14, yeah, 14, 15. Yeah, there are. So it went from about the 9 to 11 area and it jumped to 15. 15,000 contracts, and then all of a sudden it pulls back. So if you get a brand new move to make a new high above this high that was made at 28, right here, 28,1250, I think you're going to find that the new buy is coming in. And to me, this will be really important, because it's saying, aha, the selling was intense, but now you have a chance for new buyers to come in. Now, the reason why I want you to go through this little story right here is because, look at this. In the Dow, we've really just gone sideways for quite a while. I've been talking about this for a while, saying there's a consolidation in the ChapmanWave automated levels. Let me just do that. I hope this is the chart. Yep. No, it isn't. Yeah, it is. You had all these green lines. And I said we can call this a dark news cloud cover, but I'm making it in gray because it isn't anywhere as intense as it was before. So it's just to say that there's resistance, automatic ChapmanWave resistances. Now we're finally getting to some automatic ChapmanWave support levels. That's important. And why is it important? Because we are seeing a rotation in the market through the different sectors in this particular 3 to 4 week period. You've got some stocks, and I'm going to talk about them one now in the den. The question about SGMO, this is a biotech. And it's really important to see what's working, why is it working, and why would you get an incredible amount of strength in some of the very low-priced biotechs. There's a reason for that. I'll be back in a moment. Basil Chapman, Dow's down 31 now. Nice comeback.
If you're not currently using the TAS profile scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS profile scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today. Larry Pesavento is hosting a special event Thursday, May 21st from 9 a.m. until 4 p.m. Eastern Time. Trade What You See, a live trading event. For the first time in over 10 years, Larry will host a live event where you'll watch over his shoulder as he trades the markets live. You'll see how he organizes his trading day, the times most likely to generate a signal, what outside information he ignores, and more importantly, what he does not ignore, and much more. Larry will trade the market in real time, including the Euro US dollar, pound dollar, dollar yen, the Dow, and E-mini S&P, crude oil, gold, treasury bonds, wheat and soybeans, and more. When you sign up, you get a month of his daily newsletter, Fibonacci 24/7 included. For all the details on Larry Pesavento's live trading event on Thursday, May 21st, and to sign up today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
So this is very interesting. SM in the Den asked me a question here about what about the trend? Well, the ChapmanWave methodology uses Richard Ohm's trend index. Completely different. I haven't actually heard him for I don't know how long. But when I used to hear him, I used to say, Mr. Richard Ohms, you must be using it in a particular way. Congratulations. But if you don't mind, I'm going to use it completely differently. I'm only using your numbers. I don't care how you get it. I don't know how he gets it, but it's advances over declines and with highs and lows, and it's divided. But that's not the really the issue. For me, it's just the numbers. So what are the numbers? The numbers are 2.62 on the upside. That's really high. Oh, but wait a minute. We've just had a low on the downside of 0.30. So the one says there should be a 9 to 11 point rally within two sessions. That is after today. And the other one says, oh, wait a minute. There should be a Dow open, a week open tomorrow. And not only that, these 0.30s and whatever, these very low numbers, most often come in on options expiration. So this is really unusual. This must have been someone said, you know what, we're down, we're out. And they must have put in a huge amount of sell. And then somebody else was saying, you know what an opportunity. I'm doing a lot of buying. Funds I'm talking about. I'm not talking about individuals. And this is very unusual. So because of that, I don't think they negate one another. I think they're going to tell you that that's exactly what we can expect, that we can expect another choppy period where it goes negative and then it goes positive. But most importantly, where we close today, you see this green candle in the Dow? We had two red candles. Gap downs, in fact. We almost had a gap down. I think we did have a, yeah, of course we had a gap down. And then No, we didn't. Yes, we did. We opened, of course we did. We opened at 23,049. Yesterday we closed at 23,247. So there was a three-gap play, but no more. That gap was filled. So it's done a lot. Is it a wash? Well, it depends on whether you use Lysol or whether you Purinol, whatever it is. I'm going to explain what I'm looking at in a moment. So let's go. We'll come back to that, and I'll explain, because it's going to be a mix of the two, and I suspect that we're already starting to see narrower trading, and I wouldn't be surprised if. Well, I'll talk about it a little later. Let's just finish up all these other things that I wanted to do in the beginning, and I forgot. So here we go. So the Dow's up 8 now. Let's see where we are on that E-mini. Remember? Oh, my, look at that. Brand new leg. And I'm busy doing a show. Couldn't get to buy that. Oh, my. This is fantastic action. I'll tell you why. What I had said was, I initially said in the den when the question came up, I said two things. One is, the question was, why? Is it a wall of worry? And I said two things. Relief rally. And we have new participants. That's on that earlier rally going into the 11:38 rally. But they'll also get off the train quickly if it starts to pull back. Well, didn't we just see that? Look at this peak E in the 5-minute chart. Look at that pullback. It goes from 28.12 down to 27, if I can read it, 27.86. And now we're at 28.08. We're about to take that out in a new leg B. I think it's a new leg B. And what do I do for those who took my course? Remember, I immediately grabbed the arch. In fact, it was moving so quickly this morning. It's one of the few times I didn't even have a chance. I could see it, but I couldn't actually draw it in. I like to draw it in, no matter how quickly these things move. But that was really quick. That was a nice move to the upside. So look at this. You're getting to the resistance level. We watch it. And if it goes one quarter above, that is 25 cents above the 28.12.50 level, you've started a new leg B, and that's in the 10-minute chart. So this is really good action, and it's very good action because you can imagine how bearish people got at the end of yesterday and today, especially when it landed up going down a further 300 points. So got that out of the way. Now I want to just do a couple of things, and then there are a lot of questions I want to deal with. So I can't. Did I do this already? I'll do it again. SPX, I know I did it at the midday lunch hour. Update, 27.66.64 was the low for a leg B, and that puts it technically, except that the 9-period moving average has not crossed underneath the 14, but it does give you a pure technical sell signal, probably a sell mode, but I'm recording a sell signal on the S&P. Let's see where it closes. But I suspect that we are doing another kind of sideways move. You'll know if the Dow takes that 22,200 to 22,000 support anytime in the next week, that's going to be a big negative. And that's going to say, uh-oh, now we've got time and we've got price to deal with. Okay, got that out the way. So this is nice. What's the resistance? 58, the moving average resistance is up there. That's a long way to go. 40 points, 400 Dow points. Whoa, that is a lot of points. A close below 27.66, a close below 27.62 between now and Friday would be very negative action. QQQ, NDX 100, down 94 cents at 218.42. Holding the 14-period exponential moving average, having gone under it, stochastics at 71%. MACD just crossed negative, but I don't even have a signal yet. I have to wait for the end of the day, not even a sell signal. So this is still in a buy mode with a good chance that it could. If everything comes right, it could go to 227.93, up 44. Okay, just laugh at me, right? Minus 350. All right, I can't do anything right now. I'm just watching very closely. And what we're looking at here is that the weekly chart is still a spectacular V-shaped pattern. It fails if at any point in May you see the Qs underneath. Doesn't even have to close. Just has to go under 207. That's 11 points from here. That's huge. Can do it. I'm just saying. That's the level that would make me very nervous. All right. Question I had, IWM doing? IWM, this has got almost like the pattern. Yeah, TFNN, so many of the technicians use A to B equals C to D. It's just done that. In fact, it's a perfect Chapman wave. I don't want to waste time. It's a perfect Chapman wave one-to-one extension where you've got a parallel move, 1, 2, 3, 4 bars sharply down, or 1, 2, 3, after the high was made, 3 bars sharply down. You've got, 3 bars sharply down, 3 bars sharply down, yep. So you've got a 1-to-1. It's already done that, but the technicals are weak enough that it could bounce. I would not be surprised if the IWM has to do a retest of the 100. It's at 120.84 right now. It has to do a test of the 118, 117 level in the next few days. Gold, as I said, gold had a really good move. Now what I've done is I've got rid of the arch formation, right? But what I have got is a breakout above the declining wedge. Now what I like to do is I like to go back to this, put it in, to show that the lowercase h can make a lowercase m. But if the second arch doesn't break key support and goes to a higher high, that's really bullish, and I'll tell you exactly what it is when we get back. Gold is up 26 at 1743. Really nice move, but within a range, but a good move. And the dollar right now, as we go through the break, the dollar is up 13.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the opening call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The opening call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the opening call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. So just before we go on, I was asked before the show, and I want to do this right now. SGMO, which is I can never pronounce it, Sangamo. I've never heard it actually mentioned, so I don't know how you pronounce it, but I think it's Sangamo Therapeutics, Inc., trading up 28 cents at 988. And the question was, got options for tomorrow. Where do I think? Do I think it's going to break out above the high of yesterday, 2 days ago, which is 10.32? And my answer was, excuse me, with yesterday's action and the last 3 days, this is acting really well. So I would do a 120-minute chart. I'll do this right now. The 120-minute chart is suggesting that the double top that was made was more like a peak C1, C2. And what we've seen very often is that that means that instead of going to a D by one penny or fraction, it stopped dead, a little under it. But everything about the technical suggested you could count that peak as a new high, new recovery high for D, every other way except in price. Then to be conservative so that you're not waiting for a D that's not going to come, you say, you know what, I'm going to take something off right now because it might be a big C2 equivalent of a D pullback. You remember the Chapman wave? I don't want to go through that. I'll do that tomorrow. You're always looking for the fourth highest peak to make decisions. That's peak D, ABCD, the fourth highest is called D. So I would just say that at this particular point, look at the way it went to the 14-period moving average, held it, did it twice, used it as a springboard, and now it's even above the green 9 EMA. I suspect now, I don't know what's going to happen option-wise. I mean, how can anybody tell? But what I can say is that the level of action in the hit of 10.25 at 11.30 yesterday, on the 11th, I'm sorry, and on the, that's on the 13th, and on the 12th, the day before, at 10.32, is almost like a magnet. And I'm just going to say that if it manages to break even one penny above that high, then the weekly 200-period exponential moving average of 269 becomes a magnet. Right now, it's a little bit of a propellant. You can see the tough time. It's getting, as it gets closer, it has to shoot through like it did before back on the week of the 6th of December, followed through on the 13th of December 2019, and then plunged, turned around at just over 12 and ran down to 5, under 5, got cut in more than half. 61, about 53%. So now what we're looking at is this comeback. So I like the action. Everything about it I like. I can't tell you about the options. What I am going to say is this. If you have enough, the moment it takes out, if it's able by tomorrow at 10:30-ish in the morning, if by then it's hit 10:33, I would immediately take something off, even if that's not what not giving you a profit, doesn't matter. I would immediately take some off, and then I'd keep the rest, because now you can keep the rest longer, because what I would do is allow it to play out for tomorrow. Now, I go back to the trend. If the trend was so high, it's suggesting that today we've usurped some of that 9 to 11 point minimum rally in the E-mini within 2 days. You might get a little bit of follow-through tomorrow. But we might have to also do the Chapman-Wave low trend gauge, which says we could pull back just a little at the open tomorrow and then have another rally into that. That's why I'd love to see that, regardless of where we close. I'd like to see a little bit of a pullback and then a rally. Now, two reasons why I want that. One is, are you already in a nice profit? So the perfect. And this is exactly the strategy. And we will talk about it at noon, and you'll tell me where you are, what's happening. Maybe it hasn't even reached the levels that we're talking about. But I would just... because I would even take one off right now to say, you know what, that was my strategy and it's working. I know I could make a lot more money if it goes from the SGMO is trading at 9.95 and goes to 10.95. I would have made a ton. But this is a money making. You want to do this over and over. You don't want one thing to make all your money and then you start to blow it because you do stupid things. This is money management. This is the discipline. And I talk about that. I always talk about that because it's what I try my best to be disciplined, and there are moments that I look around as if to say, was that you that just bought whatever it was sold? What was your thinking? Were you got itchy fingers? I mean, what are you? and a 10-year-old. And you know, it happens. So I have to start. I'm impulsive because I like to play quick games like tennis or ping pong, or whatever it is. I like movement, and I got to be very careful. I got to do a little deep breathing there before. And that's the reason why I talk about money management. So that would be it. And then what I would do is if it breaks above 10:32 and the market is actually rallying, I would wait for the first pullback, and I might take my first exit that I just took. I might take that money and buy a really close on the opening pullback if there is. I would then have that as a trading thing, just in and I'm out, just like that. But in the meantime, use some discipline. Okay, so that was the one thing. The other thing, I had a question about T. Oh man, what was that? I'll go backwards. Dynatrace. A question about DT. Said I'd never seen DT before. That's because it's an IPO. It's been around since about the beginning of May. Oh no, what am I talking about? The beginning of May. Sorry, I was looking at the 120-minute chart. I was going to say, wait a minute, I thought that was long. Yeah, it's the beginning. It started off as an IPO in August of last year, opens at 225.50, goes to 27.48, then has a low of 20, screams down. It pulls back to 17.05 in October, and then a few months later is trading at 37.07. Whoops, it goes to a lower low, 7. Yeah, it goes down to 1710, 1705. It misses by 5 cents, making a new low. Now it's back at the high of 34. I love this kind of action. I like it. It's got a V-shaped pattern. It's got the Chapman Wave A, B, C, D, perfect peak D in that weekly chart. This is that worm formation up in the daily chart. Keeps holding the 9-period moving average, but it's not done. So I think that you have to look at this. Person who asked me looks at the longer term. So therefore, I'm saying you could get in here at 32, but it's really just a nibble. I suspect it's going to pop once and go into the 34s, but I think it's getting ready for a digestive phase. So it's just to say I'm in it. I want to get a real feel for the stock. I'm looking out because even if it had to pull back to the 28s or even the 2640 level, 200-period moving average, the way it's acted and reacted, it says whatever it does, Dynatrace Holdings LLC, what did you say there? You said, Yeah, there it is. So you said DT, peaky. Well, I can't find DT Dynatech is a new issue. Would you buy now or wait for a better price? I think they're in the right area, whatever that area is right now, and it's acting well and it's showing it. So yes, I would start the position. Where would I really put for a better price? I'd have two better prices. One is $29.50 and the other is $26.60. That's big, but it's an IPO, and I have no real history. Then we got a question about silver SLV. I'll do that as soon as we get back. And the SLV is breaking out at 1474. I like this pattern, even though it's got the cup formation. I like it because it's giving a nice base in the 14th. So I'll be.
Larry Pesavento is hosting a special event Thursday, May 21st from 9 a.m. until 4 p.m. Eastern Time. Trade What You See, a live trading event. For the first time in over 10 years, Larry will host a live event where you'll watch over his shoulder as he trades the markets live. You'll see how he organizes his trading day, the times most likely to generate a signal, what outside information he ignores, and more importantly, what he does not ignore, and much more. Larry will trade the markets in real time, including the euro US dollar, pound dollar, dollar yen, the Dow, and e-mini S&P, crude oil, gold, treasury bonds, wheat and soybeans, and more. When you sign up, you get a month of his daily newsletter, Fibonacci 24/7 included. For all the details on Larry Pesavento's live trading event on Thursday, May 21st, and to sign up today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. The gold market has taken off topside in a large way in 2020. If you want to take advantage of this sector, now is the time to subscribe to my gold report. The Gold Report took profits in four of its equities in the gold portfolio in the first week of January for a combined profit of 99.2%, with two positions left in the portfolio that have a profit of 67.5% as of January 7th. The Gold Report is a comprehensive look at the metal sector as well as the markets that move gold, which is the currency and bond markets. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to lose. Every Monday morning, I publish the Gold Report with coverage of gold, silver, bonds, the XAU, HUI, GDX, as well as more than 30 different mining equities. To see for yourself the types of profitable trades that are recommended within the Gold Report, sign up now by visiting TFNN.com. Don't miss out on the next great gold trade. Sign up today.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
So what I was asked about was silver. What I think about silver. So SLV is trading up 21 cents at 14.77. We were at about, I think, up 18 or 17 when we discussed this. And what I'd said is I like the cup formation. Gold itself has gone to a leg D, all within the arch formation. Lowercase h goes to a lowercase m. If gold at any point doesn't have to close, it just has to touch 1764.2. It has to go to 1764.3. I'll probably say 1764.5, just to say that it's really breaking above. And that says, you know what? It's trying to make a rectangle formation, and it has a chance to go to the high that was made on the 14th of continuous contract 1788.8. If at any point it pulls back here, it's still forming a beautiful rectangle formation that just says, look, it's a high-level consolidation. And we've seen that in the dollar. Look, the dollar high-level consolidation just stuck in a range. Remember, range can last a lot longer than your patience. I know that from yesterday where I was trading a range, and I kept doing exactly what I say don't do until I finally figured out, are you being – just listen to yourself. Go with the flow. And that worked out better. So you've got to do that. So what I'm looking at here is with SLV, I said if it's able – to push a little higher, it's at 1476. If we can get, what were my words? Let's see, I may as well quote myself. Fletch, this action is making the 1430s to 14.05 level good support. If you're prepared for sideways at worst, but strength over 14.83 to target the 200 period EMA at 15.17, then right here is good. And there, so I hope that those 3 cents are already right in the pocket. And yep, 1476, I like this. Yes, I could make this a peak A, peak a leg C. I'm going to call it a leg C now because you always hear in the Chapman Wave methodology, the Chapman Wave is the waveform that never sleeps. So every single peak and trough, theoretically, you want to name. Sometimes it's messy. You don't have to do that. But in this particular case, and I'm only putting a, yep, it's at 86%, and the stochastic and the MACD is good. So I can put an up arrow right here. So, yeah, it doesn't say how high it's going to go. But my other techniques are suggesting that the cup formation breakout, this is called the Chapman Wave cup and ladle breakout, and it says if you go to a new high over the left side cup lip, in this case SLV was high of 14 on the 14th of April at 1480, and we're at, ooh, we're not over it, 1477. If this leg C can spike above 1480, that says it should go to at least a D in the ChapmanWave cup and ladle, and then you've got 1480 as the support when it pulls back. That's the rule of thumb. And so far, everything's pointing that that's a real good chance. Let me just look at the 120-minute chart. Yep, everything's looking like that's a really good chance to do. Now, the next question I had was IYT. IYT is a transports. Yeah. So what was the question? India upward wedge. Oh, question was, are the transports a failure pattern for the Dow confirmation theory? Well, it's been like that for a long time. I don't really use it. I only use it when I see them actually together and I say, hey, this is a good sign. Except my experience is that when the two are moving together, this is Dow theory, you want to see the transports because that's the economy, we're moving well. I usually say that's just about close to getting some kind of a top. So all I can say is, yeah, this is nice action. I don't want to see it 136 down 218, 136.45. I don't want to see this below 129.50. That's going to be the H pattern, and that means you can keep going low, and that's not going to be a good sign for the economy. I want to talk about that. Maybe tomorrow I'll talk about that stuff. I want to get to a lot of the questions here. So the next question was, so SGM, I said DT, we did. Question I had was, right. Oh, I got the Amazon calls for tomorrow. Any thoughts? So this is Amazon, AMZN. This is the behemoth, but it's been stuck in a range. It actually hasn't gone anywhere since 24 round number high. Back 2461 was the open on the, and then 23. Oh, it had a bunch of round numbers, and then it had a high of 2461.00 on the 16th of April. It pulls back and then makes a rectangle formation, then popping to a new high of 2475 round number high, and then the lower on the 4th of May was 2256.38. It's in the range. So, Dan, you didn't tell me what options you've got. You've got calls for tomorrow. You didn't tell me which one, but I'll tell you what I'm looking at here. For the moment, Amazon is not participating out of the big 4 to 6 NASDAQ stocks. It might be stuck a little longer, and it could be stuck until Monday. This is one of those cases where if you're in the money, I'm going to suggest be very tight with this. Watch it very close. You do, I know, all day. Because if it starts to slip, it's 2364. It's down 331. If it starts to slip underneath 2, let's be as precise as possible. The low today was 2337.81. If it goes under, the low of this bar in the 120 minute is 2356. I'm just going to say to you, if you're in the money, I would say take a little bit off right here. And what I would do is if that holds, and even if it's only down, it's now down 255. Even if it's down just 1.5 points, it means you're going to have to watch it tomorrow very closely. But if it can go, today's high is 2384.60. That's a lot. That's a long way from where we are right now. So I'm going to use the moving averages here, and I'm going to say, if you see a move above 2374, that's 9 points. Now let's make it 2372. I'm going to suggest that you have a trading stop on your options, although you can't really do that, I know, but use the, you can get out with a small profit. If you have a small profit, you've already taken the gamble on Amazon. I'm going to suggest to you, I don't know how many you've got, but if you've got, take a little bit off right now, add that profit to what you were prepared to lose, and have a trading stop. And this is the only reason why I say it. Because it's not at a strike, well, 2365. I'm not sure if that's the strike price. Probably it's 2370. If the closer between now and tomorrow at 10 past 10, if there's any rally in Amazon, you're going to get your best premium. That's where I take off another little bit right there. And then I try to keep at least one or two just as a crazy day. Oh, you got 15. Then I'm going to suggest take off a little bit right now. I'm not going to tell you how much you've got to do your money management. Think of something now and then use that profit as a cushion to what you were anticipating if you were wrong. Okay? And then what I have is one-third or one part of what's left. You want a trading stop. And I'm going to go now to my 10-minute chart, and this is what I would do. Because you're playing a fine game here, and you're playing the biggest stock, and it's been dull. And it says to me, there are straddles. There are people on both sides of this trade, and that's why it can't rally, and that's why it doesn't fall. So this is what I'm going to say to you. Amazon on the 10-minute chart, yeah, it's just stuck in a rectangle formation. It's just going sideways. Take off a little bit now, and I'd just be real careful. I'd even say at 2356. I keep coming down to that 5-6 number. At 2359, take a little bit off and just leave the rest. And then I would just say, let's look at it again tomorrow.
I'm certain
I'll be back
you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability. And for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
So, folks, this is amazing. This is exactly what we did in my all-day webinar. If you want to still check out everything that's relevant to today or any other day, check out that webinar. It's still available. It was an all-day webinar. I sent out chart formations, the whole lecture itself, plus the ad-lib stuff during the day. So Dan was looking at this, and we were looking at it. I said, rectangle formation, it's got to move right away. So it went from 23.65, just hit 23.75.39. So that's why you want to be using these strategies. Look at this beautiful cup formation in this left side, right side price time match in the 2-minute Amazon chart. So I hope, Dan, you're able to use this to your benefit. Great. Good timing. Dan rules with Amazon right there. So it looks to me like you could now take some of that money and have a bigger stop and keep as much of the position as possible. Let's see what happens. So what we're looking at here, folks, I got a bunch of questions. GT, I'm going to answer. You got some really good statements that you made about the Dow, the relationship. I don't see this as a relationship to 2000. You remember, markets make lows. I've been talking about this for years and years and years. Markets make lows in a hysterical pullback to the day. But tops get spread out. January 2000, January 14 or so was the top, and then you had to wait until March before the SMHs are there and the SPX, the S&P 500. 237, 4.96. Go, Dan. Amazon, looking good. SGMO, what did you just say about that? Yep, this is also working. 10.10, up 49 cents. Beautiful. Hey, we should do this more often. Intraday, we'll do some. We'll show you the ChapmanWave technique intraday. All right, so now we're looking at, I shouldn't be so excited about it. We're up 135 in the Dow, and I'm doing the show, and I never did any trading for the last hour. Well, okay, that's fine. That's I'll live. This is an outstanding action. This is what I want you to see. That's why I say to my subscribers, we're going to have to just wait. We've actually added to our cash position. I'm looking at new stocks. We're trying to get some new stocks. The Bank of America area, we're out of that. That, I think, is stuck. That we have to watch much closer. So we've got good cash to put to use. We'll see what happens. Folks, have a great day. Stay tuned for, you've got Steve coming up. You've got Dave White. You've got Tunnelbot. I'll be back.